Hi everyone and welcome. My name is Rachel Hsu and I'm an associate editor at Devex, a media platform for the global development community.
And my name's Naomi Mahara and I'm a producer with Devex.
We've recently launched a series called Voices of Change, which is about women transforming politics. It talks about how far women have come and how much more really needs to be done. The series is sponsored by the National Democratic Institute, whose new podcast series, Changing the Face of Politics, is out now on Spotify and iTunes.
In this podcast series, women leaders from around the world interview each other about their experiences as politicians and activists. We've taken a listen to some of the most recent episodes and some of the upcoming episodes and chosen our favourite quotes. So let's dive in and take a listen.
For our first clip, we're hearing from Michelle Bachelet, former President of Chile and UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, interviewing Nighat Dad, Executive Director of the Digital Rights Foundation in Pakistan. Here's Nighat Dad talking about the gender digital divide and how that's had an impact on women in her home country.
During COVID-19, when the world moved on to digital spaces, we have seen regions in our country being deprived of education because they are deprived of internet. How are these people expected to raise their voices and gain support? They have been cut off and there is no communication in the region. And, you know, like men still finds and catches mobile network signals while walking up to the mountains because they are allowed to go out and they can reclaim public spaces. Women in those far-flung areas are not allowed to reclaim public spaces. Hence, they are completely deprived of communication. And I believe this too weakens a democracy, especially in the digital era.
In the next clip, we'll hear an excerpt from Nighat Dad's interview with Mimoza Kusari-Lila, member of the Kosovo Parliament and former Deputy Prime Minister of Kosovo. In this clip, she talks about the state of women's representation in politics around the world.
Women parliamentarians are about 25%, and women in ministerial position are 21%. But yet, we have to keep in mind that women are 50% of the world population. They are not 21%, nor 25%. So the representation of women and this gap needs to be closed. And I think there is a lot of effort that needs to be put in, a lot of encouragement for girls and women. And again, a lot of alliances that need to be built with men who are open into accepting and also working together with women. And my belief was always that we need to be active in politics, not to act like men or to replace men, but to present a new way and method of doing politics, of being involved in politics. And that is, women in politics bring new perspective.
In the following excerpt, Mimoza Kusari-Lila talks to Seyi Akiwowo, a former local councillor in the UK and now CEO of an NGO working toward ending online abuse through education, campaigns and advocacy.
I do think there's this kind of like pressure to appear, look and feel more less emotional, whatever that means, and more like a man, because that's what mainstream media have put out there is what we want and need. And I definitely think if I was a man, things like caring responsibilities, things like you know, having like my clothes ironed for me and prepared for me, I think that those things would have also been a lot easier to allow me to focus on my career a lot more, whereas being a woman, that's not necessarily been the case.
In this next episode, Seyi Akiwowo talks to Ambassador Bi-khim Hsiao, a Taiwanese politician and veteran of international politics. Here's a clip where Ambassador Bi-khim describes her experience of entering politics as a young female during the time of Taiwan's transition to democracy.
Actually, being, you know, there in politics myself, you feel that all the theories that you study are nothing in comparison to the hardships that you actually face in politics. All the stereotypes on women, all the prejudices. Mm. You know, I was even falsely accused of having an affair. The assumption that women are in certain positions because of certain sexual connections, I think that was a horrible accusation. And I've actually felt so angry that I wanted to fight it and stand for myself. But it was not easy as a young woman.
So those were our favourite moments from the podcast series so far. And it was just really fascinating to hear from such a range of women from different backgrounds and countries and cultures, to hear them sharing this knowledge and their experiences between them, I think could really inspire listeners.
You know, just a range of experienced women from an older generation who've been through many more different challenges, I suppose. And then you've got these younger women who are also still facing challenges, but in various ways. Yeah, there's quite a lot of topics, I suppose, interesting points to think about from a personal and political perspective, I think. So those are our top moments from this particular batch of podcasts. Join us next time, as we'll be doing another roundup in a few months' time.
In the meantime, you can find out more about how women are transforming politics by visiting voicesofchange.devex.com. And click on the link to listen to all of the episodes in NDI's Changing the Face of Politics podcast series. See you next time.